Tom, transitioning into retirement can be a time of anxiety for many people, but having the right advocate in our corner can make a huge difference. Okay. And here to talk about the power of advocacy is Senior Vice President of Physicians Mutual and our good friend, Bob Gunia.
Hey, welcome back, Bob. Thank
you. Great job at the mailbox wall, by the way.
Good to be here.
I know.
Listen, let's just jump right into this because it's really not uncommon for people to be a little bit anxious when they're making these big decisions about our future.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Why is it such a challenge, you think?
Well, there's no doubt it is a challenge when you think about transitioning into retirement. Interesting, at the University of Southern California, there's a center that looks into the decision-making process of people planning for retirement. Lots of research. And so the research tells us two important things. One, as we get older, the clock speed of our brain, our raw cognitive power, does slow down. But that's offset by the fact that, you know, with age comes wisdom. And there's a lot of lessons that we've learned throughout life.
Interesting.
But when it relates to these decisions, when it comes to retirement, there's no learning curve.
Right.
There's never a decision early on in life about whether or not I should enroll in Social Security when I'm 62 or 70. So that lack of experience is what makes it challenging. It's something completely unfamiliar.
Right. So it's not necessarily that the subject matter is difficult to learn. It's just the fact that we don't have any experience in making decisions like these.
Correct. And unfortunately, because of that lack of familiarity, people sometimes avoid those important decisions and they just put it off. At Physicians Mutual, we deal with folks and it is, I can't overstate just how the anxiety is and the pressure people feel. But the good news for everyone is to know that you're not alone. People have successfully navigated through the process. You have to find an advocate, someone to help you that has reps with these kind of decisions making.
Right.
So it's important for people to know you can obtain this, you can become familiar with it, you can make a good choice.
And it sounds like the key to that is to find someone who we can trust to help us through it.
Yeah, someone that believes in you, someone that has your back, your best interest in mind is very, very important. And most common, you know, we look to our family and friends, you look to your spouse that say, you're going to be there with me, for me. But there's something else that we have to take into consideration, which is very important when it comes to family and friends. And I use the example of my wife, Teresa, and she's going to be so happy I'm using an example.
Look at Teresa. Her.
There she is.
She's very happy there, and after she hears this, she's going to be equally happy.
Listen, we'd be very happy there. I'm not sure where you are, but we'd like to come visit, Bob.
Anytime. It'd be great. Come on out. For Teresa, so Teresa's got my back, but I wouldn't ask her to help with our taxes. I wouldn't say, hey, Teresa, we're thinking about selling the house. What do you think we should appraise it for? What do you think's the value? Because she doesn't have any experience with that. And so when we get family and friends involved, when you look to social media for advice, people can be very convincing and wrong. So you need that advocate that's also an expert.
Yeah, very convincing and wrong. It's all over social media. You are so right about that. So we obviously need an advocate. What steps should we take to find the right advocate? Because like you said, you love Teresa, she's got your back, but maybe not the right advocate for this.
Yeah, exactly. You know, what's important for the start is to get some sort of general understanding yourself. If you're going to be able to interview someone to see whether or not they can help you, want to have some sense of the subject matter to know whether or not this person, I mean, they should know way more than you. And if based on your introductory knowledge they don't, then that's probably the wrong person to deal with. So what I would recommend is go to Medicare.gov. When you're thinking about transitioning into retirement, in particular as it relates to your healthcare needs, it's a wonderful website, has lots of information. You don't have to master it, but it is really good to have some sort of familiarity so when you are looking for the expert, you know you have the right person.
Okay, so these experts, there are experts out there that we can talk to help us with a lot of the specifics then, too.
Yes. When you're getting close to age 65, you will learn that the post office is alive and well because folks will talk. They get stacks of letters, of postcards. We want to help you with the transition. We know you're approaching that age. How to weigh through all that, you have to dig a little bit deeper and look to the company to make sure that they have the experience. At Physicians Mutual, we've been doing it since the beginning in 1965. So we've had a lot of experience in reps working with people. And so there's no learning curve for a company like Physicians Mutual. There may be for some others. And so it's just a good idea to look at the experience and the track record of people you're working with.
Yeah.
All right. So an unfortunate conversation, but needs to be had because, you know, things like this occur. How can we prepare for a time when we actually can't make decisions for ourselves? That's the nicest way I can say it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
No, no, but there's going to become a point when we're maybe not in a position that we can make a decision. And you need someone that has your best interest in mind. Usually it's a family member. But in some situations, there's folks that maybe they don't have anyone that's close by, or they're a widow. And so who's that good friend? Who's someone that can step in? And it could go to the fullest extent of having like a medical power of attorney, or and being able to make those kind of decisions.
Right. Okay.
But my best advice for folks thinking about this, pick someone who has the comfort and serving in this capacity. I'll use the example, you know, when physicians come in those situations and they're telling the family, this is what the situation is, you have to make a decision.
And it's very scary.
And then they leave. Someone has to be able to say, hey, wait a minute, I have a question. And in my experience, every time you stop and ask that question, they will answer it. They won't just say, no, I'm too busy. But they're not gonna just stick around and say, are you sure you don't have any questions? So that goes back to the advocate. They have to be willing to step forward and make sure that they understand what's going on with your good friend and ask those questions. It's so very important.
Someone who's not gonna be afraid to do that and put themselves on the line.
It wants to be tenacious.
You don't want someone meek.
Exactly.
And if you've been in that situation before, you know these doctors have 1,000 patients. But that's your only dad. That's your only mom. That's your only friend sitting there. So you have to really be on top of them.
And they'll be responsive to you if you prod them, if you ask that question.
I know that all too well. Yeah, I did it for my dad. Yes, you need an advocate, a very strong one.
You might be mine as well.
I'm happy to be anybody's advocate. Trust me, those doctors were not happy to see me.
But if people are indeed part of your plan, like Debbie might be, you got to let them know, right? It's got to be some communication there about that.
Absolutely. And so this is a nice, you know, since you're making all your plans for retirement, you're picking out your policy post 65, you might as well tell your loved ones that, look, I'd love you to have my back. And here's my information. I'm going to add your name to make sure that you get access to the information and be a part of the team to help me going forward.
Yeah, but speaking of that, it can be incredibly frustrating when you have someone in the hospital. You're already in a vulnerable situation. They're just trying to get medical care, and you want to ask these medical professionals, so what's going on? Tell me what's happening. And they can't tell you. What do we do to prevent that? Because that is the most frustrating thing.
I mean, there's no way to overstate that one either. It is extremely frustrating. And it's something you just don't think about, that you had to get permission to get access to your mom and dad or your sister or someone that you love. It is HIPAA regulations, and so it is mandated in order to get access to that information, they have to have permission that you have authorized it. And the reason for that, there is situations where a loved one necessarily doesn't want someone to know their health history, or someone that comes into their life, you know, at the end stage but wasn't a part of their life all the years beforehand. So designating that person is very important, not just for your providers, the doctors that are taking care of you, but for your insurance companies as well. Because you'll want to know, what does their policy cover? What's the benefit? What's the configuration? And so you need to do that with your insurance carrier as well to make sure you have authorized the people to have access to your information.
Very important.
It's such great insights.
Such great info. Bob, we love it when you're here.
I really love being here. Thank you so much.
We got to get him his own room or something around here.
We should get our own room at that little lake.
That's right. Yeah. Maybe we'll do that too. But in all seriousness, Bob, you're amazing. Thank you for all that. For more information about Physicians Mutual, be sure to go to physiciansmutual.com.